Another commissioners meeting for July 7th, 2016. We'll begin with a moment of silence followed by a pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I want to note that we did have an executive session on June the 30th dealing with personnel. Are there any additions or corrections for the June 30th commissioner meeting minutes? Hearing none, the minutes will stand approved as presented. Is there any public comment on specific agenda items? Seeing none, we'll move into the agenda. Item one, under authorizing, Budget Department adopt a resolution authorizing 2016 budget appropriations in the amount of $368,790 per listing dated July the 5th, 2016. We have several items listed under Human Resources. Item one, authorize the appointment of Leslie Haftel to Judicial Coordinator in Court Administration. Item two, authorize the appointment of Corey Chieco to Assistant District Attorney 1 in the DA's office. And three, authorize a salary increase for Christine Sadler, County Solicitor. Under Facilities, one item, adopt a resolution authorizing the chair to execute a letter to C.C. Johnson and Malhotra, P.C., out of Camp Hill, P.A., grant an extension of time for completion of the preliminary engineering phase services pertaining to the Manitowney Bridge replacement project, and this goes to December 31st of 16. Under the commissioners, adopt a resolution authorizing the appointment of Michael P. Fischetti, Reading, PA, to the Berks County Workforce Development Board for a three-year term expiring June 30th, 2019. Item two, a motion authorizing the chair of the board to execute contract agreements and amendments as furnished by the contract coordinator per attached listing dated July 5th, 2016. There are four contracts. There's one jointly with Children and Youth Services and Juvenile Probation. There are two with Children and Youth Services and one that is joint between the jail, the Berksheim, and facilities. And then a motion to ratify and confirm payments is set forth in the Comptroller's Office voucher. The listing is dated July the 5th for the week ending July the 6th, 2016. That has been signed by the two present commissioners and is with our assistant, temporary deputy, deputy chief clerk, Katie Daly.
Wow. Motion to approve the agenda as presented.
I will second that motion. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? The motion is carried. We'll move to Dennis Adams, our county treasurer, and we understand that you've been quiet. So if you can speak up a little bit.
Soft-spoken? Is that
soft-spoken?
Have you found that to be a problem?
No, but apparently the viewers do. The viewers have written in and complained.
I doubt that. This morning we have an opening balance of $199,181,423.34. balance to clear $7,515,120.15, with a leaving us with a balance of $191,666,303.19.
Thank you, Dennis. And Sandy Graffius, our county controller, for the controller's report.
Just as an aside, nobody ever confuses me with being soft-spoken. So, Mr. Adams, I will teach you.
We're wearing muted colored clothing.
We're wearing muted colors. Do you like this? We're taking pictures of our staff today to hang out in the hall. So we had to be dressed as we want to be remembered.
You're hanging the staff out in the hall?
Hanging the staff out in the hall.
Wow.
Actually, photographs.
Photographs,
yes.
Of the staff.
Accounts payable, $4,849,982. We had wire transfers this week of $1,291,000. We did not have a payroll for a grand total of $5,332,869.57.
Very good. Our CFO, Bob Patrizio, if you could give us a report on the meeting this afternoon. Fairly extensive agenda.
Good morning, Commissioners. Yes, it is.
Good morning.
We have a up to a 15-minute discussion on the library system book of source program from our library director. Mm-hmm. We have our IS director attending to give us a phone system refresh update. I will be presenting a five-year forecast update, and our director of 911 emergency management will be here to discuss a proposal for on-call compensation. And also readdressing the service center for emergency personnel.
Yeah, and by readdressing, we're talking about the addresses for designation of the courthouse and the county services center.
That is correct.
Limebach Plaza, right? One Limebach Plaza.
Oh, I didn't come up with that.
Are you
need
speechless?
A second.
And we'll leave it at that.
He's speechless.
Yes.
And that's a rarity. With that, we'll turn to Commissioner Barnhart.
Thank you, Commissioner Linebach. Based on the extensive amount of information we're going to be hearing about this afternoon at 2 o'clock, I'm going to kind of reserve myself. I have nothing further to comment on.
You're going to reserve yourself. Okay.
Yes.
We'll take that. Just two items I want to touch on quickly. We had a great Why Missing 4th of July parade, one of the coolest temperature-wise parades I remember, but it made it very comfortable for those watching and relatively comfortable for those involved in the parade.
Especially the ones wearing the suits, you know, the different mascots and that stuff.
Oh my goodness, yeah.
They put on their suits.
Definitely. For them, but great parade as always. I think I received more photographs sent to me after this parade than any parade I've ever been involved in, but a bunch of people sent photos, and it's a great parade. And then I also want to compliment the RSO, the Reading Symphony Orchestra, for the Star Spangled Spectacular that we had Tuesday night versus Monday night because of the weather. Made it impossible Monday evening, but that was a fantastic event. My wife and I were able to attend. It was free to the public. There were, I think, estimates 2,000 people showed up for the event. It's great music. The fireworks were very good, but it was a great evening out. First Energy Stadium and the Fighting Phils did a very good job hosting us for the evening. And that's all that I have. Anything from our row officer, Sandy?
Just an additional on the concert Tuesday night. I'm going to out my girlfriend. They kept announcing that there were people who had cars parked.
Don't do that, Sandy.
Parked where the fireworks were going to be held. And they were saying, these cars are on the grass. Please come and move them. And so gradually the cars decreased. And finally they had one car left.
An Impala.
And the girl sitting beside me, who was my friend, said to me, gee, that's the kind of car I have, but I'm parked at the bank.
That's what they were saying, the bank.
And I said, maybe you want to go see, because right now you might be holding up the fireworks. She gets up and leaves, and 2 minutes later they said, how are we doing with the cars? And I saw the girl down below throw the thumb sign saying the cars were all moved. 2 minutes later I get the notice from my girlfriend who said, it was my car and I have now moved it, and everybody was very kind to me. So I just want you to know that Mary Lou moved her car, which allowed 2,000 people to see the fireworks.
Wow. They only announced it 575 times during the evening.
Countless times.
No, it was interesting. The first time they just said, there are several cars parked over behind the Citizens Bank area that was blocked off. You may not park there. There will be no fireworks if any cars are left. And then they started listing what the cars were.
Yes.
I just was amazed it took that long.
Well, it cracked me up.
I kept saying, Judy. Judy Schwenk was sitting in front of us. I said, Judy, you sure that isn't your car? And she said, you know I have a Prius. I said, well, I don't know.
Well, I said to Mary Lou, if they would have said your license plate, would that have done it for you? She said, I don't really know what my license plate is. And I said, okay, fine. But she did know what kind of car she had, and she did move it because she finally left us do the fireworks.
Well, she's going to appreciate you outing her on BCTV.
I love it. I love it.
Reading Eagle is here. You might want to get the spelling of the name, Liam. So, because many people were wondering, who is that person? And if they had not been able to do the fireworks, it would have been more than wondering.
There
would have been people waiting for her at her car.
Luckily, she lives in Muhlenberg Township, so she was able to see the fireworks from home once they went off, which was fun.
Yeah, they
so she left to go home and watch the fireworks.
Yeah, she wasn't going to come back in and admit it was her.
So she went home to watch the fireworks.
Yes, and then we were allowed to because her car was going to be gone.
Yeah. Okay.
Now that I can't have the last 4 minutes of my life back, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
As long as there's nobody from the public that has anything to say, I'll accept that motion to adjourn. Meeting is adjourned.